In the comments of the pose-to-pose character rigging demonstration, there was a question about how to rig a simple character with Duik. I've shown how to rig a character with multiple layers with the green person demo, and how to rig something with the puppet pins with the coconut creature, but that's kind of a complex shape, and it's not really a typical standard stick figure that you might be using in your rigs. This video shows you how to rig a stick figure with Duik and the puppet pins. I hope you enjoy. The first thing we need to do is import our composition. You can double-click in the project panel to import it. The key here is to import it as composition retained layer sizes. One thing that makes this easier to do is go to Composition Settings, and change the background color. That way we can see everything that's going on. Now, inside Duik, we want to select a hominid rig. You do that by selecting the robot arm, and that will put all the rig pieces out. In Duik, these are called structures, and you can tell they're structures because they have an S in the front of them. One thing that's also nice to do is to go ahead and rearrange your workspace. I'm going to do that now. When you're rigging, this makes it a little bit easier to see because I have all these layers over on the left. So the first thing we can do is just move these structures out of the way so we can see what's going on. And remember, in Duik, you move everything from the root of the structure. So for example, you move everything from the thighs or the arms, and arms start on the right-hand side of the body. So arm is on this side, and then arm two and leg two are on this side. One thing to notice there's all these strange pieces for the foot, but our character doesn't have them. One of the things I'll show you is how to position those so that they work. And for this, we're going to be using the puppet pin technique with Duik, which I think is really great, but we're also going to use a hybrid approach because we have these boxing gloves here, and we don't want those to distort with the puppet pins, so we'll use those as an actual layer. But in order to do that, you still need a puppet pin for the hand. So basically, it'll be two pieces. So first, let's go ahead and pre-compose the eyes, mouth, and the body. This way we can put this all together and have the opportunity to animate it in a different composition. We'll click pre-compose, and we'll call this torso. So now we have a pre-composition with all those attributes inside there. Okay. Now we can go ahead and lock our layers. This is important. We want to always keep our artwork layers locked while we're working on this so we don't accidentally move them when we're using the puppet pins. Let's start with the arm. So I'll unlock this layer, solo it by clicking the little solo button, and then I'll zoom in a bit. We have the arm selected. Notice that there's also a glove, but we don't want to have that showing yet. But we want to make sure that we put a puppet pin right here on the arm for the hand. So I'm going to hide the glove again, grab my puppet pin tool. This is arm, forearm, and hand. Twirl out in the timeline and label them. We can select each of them and click Add Bones. Now we can unsolo the arm layer. We need the arm tip, the hand, the forearm, and the arm. We can zoom out to see it, move that into position. Now we want to reshow the glove, and we bring the arm tip down to where the glove is. So this way, the glove will not be deformed by the puppet pins. It will rotate as its own layer. And then we can parent each of these things. So unlock the glove, and this will be parented to the hand. Then the bone arm will also be parented to the hand. Forearm will to the forearm, and the arm to the arm. Then we can unsolo these layers. We can hide the visibility of the bones. And remember, we want to lock our artworks. We can go ahead and lock the bones too. So now this arm is perfectly rigged. We want to do the same process for the next arm. So we'll go ahead and solo it, grab the puppet pin tool, and add three puppet pins. On the timeline, twirl it out, label the puppet pins. Remember, in After Effects, press Enter to label. For this one, we want to label them Hand 2, Forearm 2, and Arm 2, corresponding to the left arm. Then we can click Add Bones. We can solo out the four Arm 2 layers and position them right on top of our bones. Once again, we will show Glove 2, and then we move the arm tip down to the end of Glove 2. Unlock Glove 2 and parent it to Hand 2. Relock the layer so it doesn't move. Then the bones get parented to their corresponding layers. Now we can lock these artwork layers, hide the visibility of the bones, lock the bones, hide the visibility of the structures. We can also hide the arm structures. Now we have to rig up the legs. So we'll start with the first leg, unlock the layer and solo it, grab the puppet pin tool, and drop three pins. Twirl out the mesh, select all of the puppet pins, add bones. We can solo out the leg structure layers and move them into position. Since our character does not have a foot, we can leave this part of the foot structure here. If you wanted to have a more complex character with a foot roll, we would use these pieces, but for this simple stick figure, it's not necessary. So now we can parent the different bones through the structures. Once we do this, make sure our leg layer is locked. We can lock the bones, hide the visibility of the bones, hide the visibility of the structures, unsolo these layers, and now we're ready to rig leg 2. Unlock leg 2, solo it, select the puppet pin tool, and drop 3 pins. Label the pins in a timeline. Remember, this is leg 2, so label everything foot 2, calf 2, and thigh 2. Then select all 3 pins, click add bones, then solo out the leg structure and move it into position. Now we're ready to parent. Lock the leg artwork layer and parent the bones. Now we can hide the visibility of the bones and lock them, and hide the visibility of these structures, and unsolo the leg 2 layer. Lastly, we need to take care of the torso of the character. And if you look here, it's just an orange. So what we can do is put in bones where we think the character will most likely need them. First, unlock the pre-composition torso. Grab the puppet pin tool, and then starting down, we're going to have hips, spine, spine 2, neck, and head. Now we can label these puppet pins. So we'll label them hips, spine, spine 2, neck, and head. If you wanted to have the head of a puppet character be able to pivot, you still need to put a spine tip. But since this is mainly a circle, there won't be too much motion. It's just to give it a little bit of fluidity. But you could add another puppet pin and bone labeled spine tip. Select all of the puppet pins, add bones, then lock our artwork layer. This is a pre-composition, so it covers the whole screen and is very easy to accidentally move. Place the structures in position. Now we need to parent the bones. Now we can hide the visibility of these structures, hide the visibility of these bones, lock the bones. And so now we're just about ready to auto-rig the character. So we can select all of these structures, then we can click auto-rig. So now everything is rigged up perfectly fine. We can do some cleaning up of the rig if we want to. So for example, we can change how these icons look. If we select this hand controller and we move, everything looks great, but this hand is kind of in the way, so we can make that look a little bit better. So up here in the icon, before everything happens, we have, that's the reason Duik has all of this twirled out, is so we can fix this really easily. So we can go to the icon, and we can change where it's positioned. We can lower the position down here. We can change the size, let's say maybe 150. Then we can rotate it 180. And now we have a controller that can be used, and it doesn't block our artwork. We can do the same thing for this controller. We can do the same for the feet. So if we just rotate the icon, and then we can lower the position down just a little bit. This will remind us which way our feet are pointing. And we can go to the next foot. Also, the spine and everything can be difficult to control when it's all on top of each other. So we can move the head over, we can move the shoulders over, we can move the hips over, and the spine control. And you can change the size and the alignment of these as you wish. What we want to make sure is that we have everything bending the right way. So if I pick up this controller, that leg bends right. I pick up this controller, this one bends correct. And we can change these colors. So if I click this one, I can have one side of the body be a certain color and one side of the body be another color. So I'm going to go ahead and pick, and we'll just make this be red and this be red. And then for the other side of the body, I'll make them be green. These two sections are separated. In this character, it doesn't move so much, but we can have the bottom and the top be different colors. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, so now we have contrasting colors on all the pieces. What we can do now is have these layers over here match. So that way it's very easy to tell. So we can make this one be red, and we can make this one be green as it is. This one here we can make red. So that way we can really easily see where things are. Here we'll leave that one as green. Shoulder and neck we can make as blue. Spine curve we'll leave, but we're going to change this to magenta or fuchsia. We can see it right there. Then the spine root we'll leave and change this also as fuchsia. The hips we'll make orange, and the body we'll make orange. Now you can see over here, it's much easier to see which piece is which. The last thing we want to do is in Duik, right now it is automatically calculating the appearance of these controllers. What we want to do is bake them in. This will make the rig perform better. So if we go to controllers in Duik, we can select each of these controllers. You can select all the controllers. And then we click the edit button. And we want to go ahead and bake the appearance. Make sure that everything's where you want it before this, because now when I move the icons, there's no longer the icon option. So now everything actually moves the rig. There's one other thing that we can speed up. So you notice here it has these guides. We can have those disappear. If we click each controller and we display draw guides. So that will help speed up your rig when you're animating. One of the last things we need to do is fix this. This looks pretty good, but if you look, it does this weird bendy thing. So we can make it look a little bit more fluid, a little bit more hose-like, if we go ahead and add some starch to this rig. So to do that, we're going to be very careful that we want to select each of these puppet layers on its own. So we'll start in the same order that we rigged. So we'll unlock the arm, select it, solo the layer. And the best way to make sure you're working in the right area is to come down to Mesh 1, click Deform. If you click in the timeline, Deform, and then you see the puppet pins highlighted, you know that you are working on that mesh. Click and hold on the puppet pin tool and select the puppet starch tool. Then drop some starch pins in the middle. This will keep it so it doesn't deform as much. Now, if I bend this, I get a much more fluid arm. This looks much better. Now I will do that for each of the other layers. First, solo the layer, unlock it, twirl out the timeline, select the form, puppet starch tool, make sure to relock the layer, unsolo. Unlock the leg, solo. Notice I can't see the puppet pins. Make sure you select the form. Now I can. Relock the layer, unlock leg 2, select it, twirl it out, select the form, solo the layer, lock the layer, unsolo it. Now our character has much more fluid bending of its limbs. And you can tweak this to be exactly how you want it to be. So the last thing we want to do to finish this rig is to clean up our timeline so it's much easier to animate. So to do that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to lock all the structures so they don't accidentally move. We can leave the controllers there, and then I'm going to click and drag on this shy icon for all of the pieces I don't need to see in the timeline. Click shy. Now I have a much cleaner timeline that I can animate with, and my character can be controlled with all these pieces. And you see by adding puppet pins to the body, we get just a little bit of action that we wouldn't have if we kept that as a solid layer. Happy animating, everyone. This is how you can rig a simple character with stick legs with Duik and not have the arms distort when you're working with this. If you like this content, please click subscribe. And remember that this entire After Effects project file is available for you to download in the description. If you're interested in learning how to animate this character, please watch the pose-to-pose animation video using this rig to animate a boxing scene.